First of all, prayer for me growing up was always really, the people who loved to pray were the 65-year-old women in my church that were part of the prayer ministry. And I was like, gosh, like, no wonder I thought prayer, you know, that. And then maybe when I turned 24, I remember her name was Sue. She was a prayer minister at my church at the time. And she fit the prototypical prayer minister lady. And that was when I first started having some anxiety. And she came and she prayed for me. And I remember feeling the Holy Spirit like I'd never felt before. And I was like, suddenly it went from like, oh, those cute old ladies are praying, to how can I pray like her? This is a brand new sensation for me. So began my journey to figure out what prayer really was. And I've come to a place in an understanding where prayer is not a speech to God. That's what I've been doing. I've been giving speeches to God or throwing up shotgun prayers and hoping one of them hits, as much as it is a conversation. And in a conversation, two people are talking. That means it's proven scientifically that when you're speaking, you can't hear. So if you're talking to somebody and someone's talking to you back, and if you're talking, you're not hearing anything they're saying. So suddenly prayer, so for anyone listening, it needs to shift from you talking to you talking and then you listening. Well, how can I really hear from God? What if I've never heard, I always hear people saying I heard from God, but I've never heard from God. Well, start simple. Start by asking God simple things. If you're in a conversation with somebody, this is where I started. I started asking Jesus, I would write in my journal, Jesus. Oh, and journaling is another huge thing. If you want to learn to pray, journal, 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 journal. But I would write in my journal, Jesus, do you want me to go to Chipotle for lunch? Or do you want me to go to Chick-fil-A? I would write that down. And it sounds crazy, but it would blow my mind, because I would just kind of feel, you know, again, this is hearing from God, you're gonna hear from different ways. Like, I would just kind of feel a sense like, oh, Chipotle. I was like, okay, I'm gonna go to Chipotle. And people may think I'm crazy by saying Jesus told me to go to Chipotle, but I would start going to Chipotle or Chick-fil-A, wherever I would feel him go. And every single time at these spaces that I would go, I would run into an opportunity that I know he had preordained before I got there, whether it be a conversation with somebody, whether it be, oh, this just happened the other day. So my friend Marcus is here in town in Nashville, and he goes, hey man, oh, we're having coffee. He's like, are you hungry? I said, yeah. He said, and we were actually talking a little bit about prayer. He's like, where do you want to go lunch? I go, well, let's ask Jesus. And again, he looked at me like I'm nuts. And he said, why would Jesus care where we go to lunch? And I was like, because he cares about everything. Well, I get, yeah, you're right. I mean, I believe that. So let's pray. So we prayed. And Marcus said, oh, I feel like he said, let's go to Thai Phuket, which is a Thai restaurant. I said, okay, let's go. We go to Thai Phuket. This was 3 days ago. We're there. We're having pad thai. We leave the restaurant, walk into our cars, kind of giving each other a hug. And this guy walks out of Thai Phuket and walks up to Marcus and says, hey man, do you ever like set up shop at Crema, this coffee shop here in Nashville? And Marcus is like, yeah. He's like, I saw you there the other day. And the Holy Spirit just really put you on my heart. I don't even know who you are, but like, I prayed for you as you walked out. And I just saw you here at Thai Phuket. And like, obviously, like, this is just weird. I would never do this, but can I pray for you? And Marcus looked at me like, and I was like, see, yeah. Like, he cares about the small things. Right. And so this is supposed to be normal. But again, it blows our minds. But this is Jesus, the Holy Spirit, and God the Father has ordained our life to be in conversational intimacy with him. And when we do it every single day, we're going to have these mind-blowing experiences all the time. It's really cool.